But you have many, many other business lines. We just keep hearing about chips because, I mean, look, I love the high-performance computing. Yeah, I love what AMD does, what NVIDIA does. But we're talking about these full-featured chips. Now, in the end, many of them are made, say, by Global Foundry. Well, you can't call Global Foundry, can you, and jump the queue?
No, or TSMC that's moving in Arizona, by the way. But, you know, no, and that's the issue. And that's where a lot of these companies got caught short. They might have not had as much electronic content in their products prior, and they didn't change their supply chain methodologies and went to the lean and, you know, and then kind of bang the fist on the table to get more product. And it just doesn't work that way. I mean, you can't jump the line. And there's 12, 18, 24-month periods of cycle time, okay, from the time an order's dropped to when it can be shipped when there's constraints, because you just can't bring, and our suppliers, and you've had them on, you've had one on recently, Intel, some others, they just can't change the production that quickly. They're adding capital, but you're talking 18 to 24 months before you see any throughput.
But here's my problem. I'm a CEO, okay? I want to deal with what I make. I don't want to deal with what's inside what I make. But if I were to call Phil and say, listen, I've been 100 years, my company has worked with your company 100 years. Will you show us how to do this? Show us what supply chains mean. This is not a new environment. I mean, isn't it better that they do it with you than if they try to figure it out and reinvent the wheel themselves?
Well, I obviously have a biased view. The answer is yes. And we're getting those calls. We have what we call supply chain architects. That's what they do. And they come out of supply chain backgrounds. And we actually help these customers and suppliers, because a lot of our suppliers, they're good at manufacturing, right? They're good at marketing their products, maybe designing their products. But they'd rather use us to go drive the supply chain piece, because we're right in the center of it. We're a great aggregator, Jim. So we're dealing with thousands of forecasts on a daily, weekly, monthly basis that we take in electronically. We manage it. We put the analytics around it. Then we send the feeds to the supplier upstream, as I like to call it. Then we say, okay, what kind of buffers do we need? What kind of buffers are we willing to invest in together so we all get a fair ROI? And you'd be surprised, it's not really that much, particularly the cost of capital today and the cost of inventory. Having a little bit of a buffer is not a bad thing. Inventory kind of through the 80s and 90s got, it's kind of a bad word. Inventory's not a bad word if it's good inventory.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com. Or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.